The question I get now more than ever is how will the presidential election impact the real estate market? This year will certainly be remembered as one of the most challenging times in all of our lives. We got hit with a worldwide pandemic, a recession which caused historic unemployment, and a level of social unrest perhaps never seen before in history, certainly not in our lifetime. And it's changed the way we all live. Only the real estate market seems to be totally unaffected. And as some forecasts show, there may be more homes purchased this year than last year. As we're coming to the end of this tumultuous year and we're preparing for perhaps the most contentious presidential election, I think it's important that we look at the impact past elections have had on the real estate market. Before we go any further, I'm declaring my intent to run. Forget this bozo and forget this bozo. I want to be your realtor for life. I want your vote to be your realtor right now and forever. No term limits. My policy and platform is simple. I will do whatever it takes to ensure your real estate goals are achieved. We will save you more money than any other method of buying or selling. Or my name is not Chris Igo. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty. Vote for IGOE. All right, back to business. I suspect nobody's going to vote for me due to my great singing skills. But the question at hand is there a drop-off in home sales during a presidential election year? BTIG, which is a research and analysis company, looked at new home sales from 1963 through 2019 and noted that in non-presidential years, there's a 10% decrease in November compared to October. This is just the normal seasonality of the market, the slowdown in activity that's usually seen in fall and winter. It also noted that in presidential election years, the typical drop increases to 15%. And the report goes on to explain why. Potential home buyers become more cautious in the face of national election uncertainty. Now you may ask yourself, are those sales lost forever? And the short answer is no. No market likes uncertainty. And the caution is temporary. And it ultimately results in deferred sales as the economy, jobs, interest rates, and consumer confidence all have far more meaningful impact in the home purchase decision than a presidential election result in the months that follow. Now, in a separate study, chief economists agreed that those purchases are just delayed until after the election. History suggests that the slowdown largely concentrated in the month of November. In fact, the year after a presidential election is the best of the four-year cycle. Demand for new homes is not lost because of election uncertainty. Rather, it simply gets pushed out to the following year. So will it really matter who's elected? To some degree, yes, but not in the overall number of home sales. Consumer confidence plays a far more significant role in a family's desire to buy a home. Which begs the next question, how might consumer confidence impact the housing market post-election? And the analyst report covered that as well. A change in administration might benefit trailing blue county housing dynamics. And the re-election of President Trump could continue to propel red county outperformance. But again, overall sales should not be impacted in any significant way. So here's the bottom line. If mortgage rates remain near all-time lows, the economy continues to recover, and unemployment continues to decrease, the real estate market should remain strong up to and past the election. So vote for me, Chris Igo, for your realtor for life. And God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night from the light of above. This advertisement was paid by the Elect Chris Igo as your Realtor for Life campaign, and I approve this message.